COVID-19 vaccines. Four countries hacking vaccine developers. Hacking of COVID-19 vaccine intellectual property should not come as a surprise. But when multiple nations are doing the same thing, the situation looks bigger than it seems. That's what the former head of the Cybersecurity and Infrastructure Security Agency said. Four countries were detected doing some form of espionage or spying related to vaccine IP. CISA's former head Chris Krebs said, "What we had been thinking through at CISA was not just the vaccine developers, but their entire supply chain and really trying to look for those critical weak spots." According to CNBC, Krebs not only associated the hacking attempts with Moderna, but also with others working on vaccines. The attempts might be observing early designs of upcoming vaccines or vulnerable points. If vaccine developers were penetrated, the intellectual property and supply lines might be at risk of potential harm. Krebs noted that China, Iran, North Korea, and Russia were doing those acts. However, he didn't specify if the threat actors were traced back in these nations or if they were state-backed. The former CISA's head was not the only reporter of COVID-19 cyber threats. IBM also reported threats. Last week, the COVID-19 vaccine code chain was targeted by a global phishing campaign. The IBM Security X-Force monitored the vaccine supply chain for any unusual activity. An assigned task force unveiled phishing attempts on the code chain specifically. This part of the supply lines is critical in vaccines highly sensitive to temperature changes. Although the task force could not establish where the threat actors originated, they successfully detailed the phishing campaign. The adversary impersonated a business executive from Haier Biomedical. The company is a legitimate member of the code chain optimization platform for COVID-19. As a disguised employee, the actor sent phishing emails to organizations. The emails were designed to obtain credentials, which would matter in accessing sensitive information in the vaccine distribution. Multiple targets, including the European Commission's Directorate General for Taxation and Customs Union, were identified in the emails. Most targets were global organizations based in the Czech Republic, Germany, Greater Europe, Italy, South Korea, and Taiwan. The emails were directed to select executives of particular sectors, including IT, finance, procurement, and sales. These sectors are closely related to the cold chain. Right now, the threat actors are unlikely to push extra time and resources to the same tactic. This is because the cash-out pathway is quite unclear.